So previously in this series, we've talked about the hardware you need to be a programmer or to program. But in this video, I want to go through the software tools that you need and what costs are associated with those tools so you become a programmer. So let's talk about that now. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. So let's get into it. Software development tools. What do you need? But more importantly, perhaps, what do they cost? Well, before I go into too much more detail, the great news is that most programming languages, when you're starting out, you're not going to have to spend any money. I'm going to quickly go through some languages, but this advice will apply generally to any programming language. So let's look at Java and Kotlin, two very popular programming languages. The great news about those is the IDE, the Integrated Development Environment, or editor, that's where you type in your code. There's lots of different vendors out there who make the products, and pretty much all of them are free. So looking at JetBrains, the IntelliJ product, JetBrains is the company, the IntelliJ product comes in a community edition, which is completely free, and that's the one that I recommend most people starting out would use. And they've also got an ultimate edition, and the ultimate edition is the one where you have to pay money. But we'll talk more about the advanced or ultimate editions of products a little bit later. And there's other products like NetBeans is another example, Eclipse. So there's lots of different choices there, and pretty much all of those or all of them are free in their basic versions. Now, if you wanted to get into Microsoft products, say C Sharp is one example, Visual Studio by Microsoft is another product that's also got a free edition. I think it's called the Community Edition, if memory serves. But there's also, they've got Advanced Edition. They've got a Professional version, Enterprise versions as well. And it's only once you get into the Professional or the Enterprise editions that you start having to pay for those. And they're both fully featured, and they work with most, if not all, of Microsoft's languages. So you can do your .NET development, C Sharp, which I know is part of .NET, but also the embedded C coding and also C++, and their other programming language, Visual Basic, is another one in the .NET platform. So most of those languages work nicely in their Integrated Development Environment, their IDE. And again, there's a paid version and a free version, but when you're starting out, you certainly don't need to spend any money. That's Microsoft's options. If you're getting into something like Python, well, the great news about Python is there's also free editors there. And another one, IntelliJ actually, which I talked about at the start of the video, that's also got a Python module. You can, if you've got IntelliJ already installed, it's free. You can download the plugin into IntelliJ, and that gives you Python support, and you can do all your Python programming in there. That's also cross-platform as well, which is fantastic. And I would suggest you look at that. IntelliJ, again, is great for that. But there's also a dedicated product called PyCharm. PyCharm is really just IntelliJ, but optimized for Python. And it's, in actual fact, it's the same as if you downloaded and used IntelliJ with the Python plugin. But some people prefer to buy that. So that's a great option. And other programming languages in general, a great option for you to look at is, again, by Microsoft, Visual Studio Code. So this is a different product than Visual Studio. Visual Studio Code is an open source editor, and it works for pretty well, I won't say all programming languages, but there's so many languages that it supports, it's not funny. It's also cross-platform, Windows, Mac, and Linux, a great place to start. Not the easiest of editors to learn, so if you're starting out as a programmer, I'd probably steer you more towards the other editors I talked about earlier in the video, but Microsoft make a great editor. Their Visual Studio product is fantastic, and that's flowed into Visual Studio Code. And again, it's not only cross-platform, but it's open source. And there's contributors. You can contribute yourself if you're a developer to that product. Every month they release a new version on the three platforms. Again, Windows, Mac, and Linux, which is fantastic. So I would suggest that because that supports most programming languages and again is free. You don't need to pay anything there. And what I didn't say with Visual Studio, by the way, their full sort of blown IDE, that has got a Windows version which has been out for probably 20 plus years now. It's been constantly evolved, or it has constantly evolved since then. But also there's a Mac version as well. They haven't got a Linux version to my best of my knowledge at the moment, but I wouldn't be surprised at all if they release that at some point in the future. So the bottom line here is that all the basic tools you need to get started as a programmer are generally free. And that's fantastic because it means you can just concentrate on learning a programming language and not have to cough up, so to speak, too much money or any money. But once you start getting more into, you've been through a few programming courses or you've started a programming job, then it might be time to start looking at paid versions of software. Now, obviously, if you're working for someone, then perhaps they've already got the paid version and you may not have to pay for that yourself. But you might decide to get into some of those ultimate or advanced or professional versions. And the difference between those and the basic versions that I've talked about is they offer specific functionality for more advanced software. So in the case of IntelliJ, for example, they offer the Ultimate Edition, and that's got advanced tools for things like Java Enterprise Edition. So when you're starting to work with applications that work with big data sets and so forth, and written for enterprise customers, so it's sort of largish type code, they've got functionality in there to make things easier for you as a developer when you're doing that specifically. So that there could be a stage at some point in the future where you have been through the basics and you're wanting to focus and specialize, then you can start looking at those advanced tools. And likewise, there's lots of different toolkits and lots of other frameworks and so forth that are free, but there's also some that you can actually pay for as well. Now, in the case of IntelliJ, for example, there's a heap of plugins, and now most of those plugins are free. So if you want to perform a particular bit of functionality, chances are that someone's written a plugin for that, and you can go to their plugin. Basically, there's a plugin area that you can go through in the software, and you can search for a particular bit of functionality and just load in the plugin. So the good thing is that a lot of these IDEs or editors have got that functionality built in, so that you may, even if you want to specialize in a specific thing, you may not have to spend any money still. But again, in the case of those advanced ones, you will get to a stage at some point. Again, in the example I used for IntelliJ was the Java Enterprise Edition. If you're using that sort of functionality, then chances are you'll need to invest in the Ultimate Edition, or you'll find that there's only support for a particular bit of functionality in that Ultimate Edition. Because, I mean, think about it, these companies who make these editors, Microsoft and JetBrains and so forth, they're actually in it to make money. So, you know, they need to make money somehow, and I don't begrudge them doing that. The great thing, though, is that a lot of the free versions will stand you in good stead, and you won't have to spend any money. Now, two other things I want to continue with, just to reiterate, the free versions that I'm talking about, they aren't trial versions. They're fully featured versions that don't expire. So I'm not suggesting that you need to, you can only use it for 30 days and then that's it. They're fully featured, and basically you'll never have to upgrade if you don't want to. The other thing I didn't talk about, I just wanted to briefly mention mobile app development as well, because there's a couple of options there. We've got for the Android platform, Android Studio is the free platform, the free software that Google provide. Fantastic for Android app development. It's constantly evolving and constantly being updated and fixed. And coincidentally, under the hood, Android Studio is actually JetBrains IntelliJ Community Edition. So you'll see that if you've been using IntelliJ and you switch over to Android Studio, you'll see a lot of similarities. And that's because it's under the hood, the products are basically the same. What Google have done is over the top of that, they've added Android functionality that's specific to the Android platform. So that's also cross-platform, so that'll work on Windows, Mac, and Linux. And swinging over to the Apple side of things, if you want to get into iPhone, iPad, or even Mac apps, then Apple have got a product, Xcode, and that will allow you to do that. That's also free. Android Studio was free, and so is Xcode. The downside about Xcode is that it's Mac only, and that's obviously Apple's infrastructure. That's their platform, but it is free, so you'll need a Mac generally, or you can use something called a Hackintosh, and I'll put a link in the video description to a video about Hackintosh if you want to understand what that is. But the bottom line here, hopefully now, is you've got a good idea that pretty well all the basic things you need are free, and it's only when you start getting into more advanced things, more advanced functionality, you've got more experience on your belt, that you can consider the need to actually spend money. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.